Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the fifth episode to create an e-commerce website using WooCommerce. In the previous episode, we created a custom template and set it as a home base. Today, we'll work on Hero Carousel using Slick JS and custom post type UI. First of all, let's add custom post type UI. So open your admin panel, go to plugin and click on add new. Then in the search box, you can search for custom post type UI. And then click on install now. Click on activate. And your custom post type UI is activated over here. Now, in order to create a new custom post type UI for Hero blog, go to this custom post type UI. Click on add or edit post type. Then fill up this information. I will write hero. Then go all the way to the bottom. And then I will select title, editor and feature image. And then click on add post type. Now, if you want to create a new hero, then hover on this hero and then click on add new. Then you can add title, content and feature image. So I will just copy from my notepad. Add the content in the classic block. Publish. Again, click on add new. Then you can add the content and feature image. Let's add one more hero. So again, click on add new. Add the content and feature image. Once done, click on publish. Now you can click on all heroes if you want to see a list of heroes that we have created. And so far we have created 3 heroes. Now it's time to work on the code, so open your home template. Now I want to remove this custom content and instead I want to create a new section with a class called hero block. And inside that section, I want to add the PSP code. And inside this post type, I want to add hero. Hero is the name of post type that we had created recently. If you want to verify them, then just click on custom post type UI and then click on add or edit post type. And then click on edit post type. So that name should match exactly to this name. Now, if you want to show some content or title, you can simply add the underscore content inside PHP tag. Now if you want to test it, then go back to your site and refresh them. And now you are seeing three different content from three different hero blocks. Now since everything is working, let's add the div and the class name. So the first thing I want to add is a div with a class called holder. Inside holder I want to add container, and then inside container I want to add content. For the title I want to add h3 and span tag, and then I want to call the underscore title. After this title I want to show the content, and after the content I want to show a button, and the name of the button is shop now, and I want to add a class called btn. Now refresh the site and you should see some changes. Now let's add the image, and for image I want to add a background image. So inside this holder div I want to add style attribute, and inside style I want to add background. Now all we need is the image URL, and to get that, over here I'll add this code, and then we will just call that code inside the style attribute. Now refresh the site and you should see all the images. And now the final thing we have to do is to work on Slick.js. So open the new tab and find for Slick.js. You can then open the first link. Click on get it now. And then copy this CSS CDN link. Open your header.php. Just after the font awesome CDN, you can add another CDN for Slick.js CSS. I'll just write https, then copy the JS CDN link. And this time you can add them in footer.php. Again, I will add https over here. Then in order to work on this Slick.js, we might need jQuery CDN link as well. So in new tab you can search for jQuery CDN, and you can copy this minified jQuery CDN link and paste it just before this Slick.js CDN link. Now let's add main.js so that we can add our custom script. So open your project folder, go to WP content, themes, eFashion, assets, JS, and then you can copy any one of the JS file. Just rename it to main.js and then open that main.js and remove all the content. Now let's import this main.js in this footer.php. So just after Slick JS, you can add main.js. And now if you want to navigate to this theme folder, then you have to add this PHP code. And since our main.js is inside this assets and JS folder, you simply have to write the full path over here like this. Now go back to your Slick site and then click on demos, and then you can copy the script and paste it in your main.js. I'll just write a comment over here and paste it over here, and my class name is hero block, so I will just use this class name and replace it over here. Now let's refresh the site and your carousel should work. Here you go. And according to our design, we have got this pagination in dots and not in the arrow. So open your Slick site again and click on setting. So the first thing we have to do is to remove this arrow, so copy that arrow. And make it false. Then we need the pagination in dots, so we need to copy this dots and then set it as true. Now refresh your site again and you can see pagination in dots. Now our hero carousel is looking exactly the same as in our design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll create all products and show my recent product using Slick.js. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.